Teddy was immersed in impenetrable darkness. He allowed himself to be lulled by the void. No little girl to save. No enemies to fight. Finally, he could rest. So what was the nagging sense of discomfort, which was becoming more and more intense? Could the thought of having abandoned Alicia cause as much pain as being pierced by a needle?
Ah! Teddy's eyes widened.
A porcelain doll was tending to his wounds. As he was looking around in confusion, the witch cat hovered into view. He shivered. Was this the end? The cat reassured Teddy that nobody meant him any harm. But the time had come to clarify. To clarify what? That the demons he had killed were Alicia's dream guardians, the defenders of her inner realm. But how could the guardians have taken on such monstrous forms? The cat explained everything. Alicia's subconscious was reacting violently in order to protect her, like an immune system attacking a virus. And this virus had a name. Lighty. So that sneaky little bug had been trying to worm herself into Alicia's subconscious to corrupt her. But why had Lighty chosen him to carry out her evil plan? The answer was simple. He was the strongest and bravest of Alicia's guardians. Was he really one of the guardians? How could he have forgotten? When Alicia had abandoned him in the chest, a crack of weakness had opened in his soul, giving Lighty the opportunity to put her wicked plan into action. She had wiped a vital part of his memory with a spell, causing him to forget his true role and his power. The frightful fairy had tricked him, turning Alicia's most stalwart defender into a ruthless weapon to attack her with. The defeat of each monster had nourished Lighty's magical powers, allowing her to grow stronger and stronger. Teddy was aghast. So that was why the witch cat seemed to have always known him while he couldn't remember anything. He had forgotten that she had once been his most trusted ally in protecting Alicia. He had forgotten that the cat was a unique creature that resided in the deepest part of the girl's subconscious. The cat was her limbic system, her superego, the supreme entity that defended her unconscious self. And as such, her powers could only be fully manifested in the furthest reaches of Alicia's dreams. Events unfolded in the rest of Alicia's dream world. At first, the cat was enraged as she watched Teddy and Alicia's dreams, but she knew that mere words would not be enough to convince him of Lighty's true nature. She decided to try provoking him, mocking his beloved mistress, hoping that his anger would reawaken his memory and rekindle his powers. Unfortunately, things didn't go according to plan. The cat was thus forced to play a more subtle game, lurking in the shadows, waiting for Lighty to reveal her true nature. Each time the witch cat met Teddy, she had absorbed as much of his power as possible in order to heal the wounded guardians. The fog in the bear's head was slowly clearing. He still had a lot of unanswered questions, but his anger at Lighty's betrayal and his determination to save Alicia awakened a strength that had lain dormant for too long. A burning fire, ancient, powerful, and reassuring, enveloped him. Teddy had become more savage, a feral creature. To fight a nightmare, you have to become one yourself. He finally understood. The time had come. The witch cat sent him back to the world of dreams. But nothing was as he remembered.